Your sword is useless here.
It's me, Senua.
It's so loud.
It's not her.
So full of hate. I just want to help them. Tell me what to do.
Your father wants them to go away. And he only hurts me to silence them.
But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They say that I'm already dead.
No,
and that they want me with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't listen
to them.
Do you see them?
Do you see their faces?
He's coming! Senua! Help me! Help! Get me out of here! Don't go!
Where has she gone? She's disappeared again.
She shouldn't be here. She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started. When her mother lost her smile. Her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld, he said. It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill of fear. I don't talk much about her father, Zinbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now, does it?
Just keep going.
She'll have to go in.
She will. She has to make it.
going. Hidden in plain sight. She has it. You have it. Where's the next? Do not divide. I can feel it. Do not divide.
Why?
These pointless rooms. Time.
So.
Mother.
They're meaningless.
Your mother's here. What if you collect them and there's nothing behind the door?
Save Dillian.
It's just another trial.
Just another trick.
Just to distract her from her real mission.
You think you know, but you don't.
Your mother is dead. You don't know anything, or is she?
Dillian is dead.
Rayan the Dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rayan would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rayan reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rayan go in search of Fafnir.
She has it.
She did it. She's done it.
This place. It reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a young girl. Imprisoned in her room at night. The faces in the dark coming through the wall. time she realized that only she could see them. Her father, Zinbel, could see the monster in her.
Thank you. anywhere without your light.
Take the torch and move. Lighting the torch.
It's not gonna help her.
She's lighting the light. I think you're safe.
Darkness.
Do you think you can keep her safe?
If you light the torch.
The darkness is real.
You're wrong.
Light burning. Safe.
Searching for weakness. It found your mother and used her to trap you in here.
Did you see her die? I don't remember. I was only 5. They told me she escaped the darkness, that she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here? Mother. did you leave me? This darkness, it's spreading. Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Tilly.
The beast is down there.
No, no.
She knows the beast is down.
He's always watching you.
The beast is there. You're never safe from him.
Be careful.
She needs to find Ilya.
She's found it.
She lost it and she has to find it.
Feel it. Feel it.
She hid the torch on it.
You're never gonna find it.
He's gone! He's coming back to us.
Dillian's soul.
And it will take
take it.
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all who owned it. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure. Although Sigurd kills the dragon, Rian wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rian also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
Stop!
Thank you. are you doing?
You killed us.